Hello guys, today I'm going to show you how to get a less laggier Mac. Now, it's very simple and easy. What basically happened to your Mac is just that you probably downloaded a lot of stuff, ordered some softwares on your Mac that make it very laggy. Sometimes the softwares take a lot of gigabytes away and it's very annoying and it gets everything laggy. So, I don't have many show you because I already dumped my gigabytes and stuff, but I'll delete some. So right now my Mac is still a little laggy, but so I'm going to show you how to be doing this stuff. I'm going to go to Finder and I see all these stuff. You want to search through every one of them and you want to make sure that you don't have anything that you don't need. Documents. Alright, let me see if I don't need anything. So I probably don't need, let's see. Well, I think I actually need everything here, but you probably need to have some stuff in like documents and stuff. I don't need this. I don't know why I have two documents folders, but yeah. So then like you have to delete stuff that you don't need. I don't need these forge jars anymore. What else don't I need? I don't need this chart, or do I? Yes, maybe. Config, what's this? Don't need config anymore. Don't need still hungry. So yeah, just do that. Just do all that stuff. But what else do you want to do is you want to check this. The iMac should be connecting. Right. If that doesn't work, you don't have to do it though. But if you do it, it does make it very, very less laggier. Applications. What kind of applications you don't need? I don't need this thing. Cancel. So I guess I can't do that. Just take anything you don't need out of here. When you go to the today thing, it's nothing basically. It's just everything that you did today. Yesterday, it's nothing. Basically. Alright, so now Macintosh HD, you want to check this. So library, you don't have to check every single one, but you want to make sure you check like those ones, like these desktop pictures. Sometimes you'll need some of them. Just delete the pictures that you don't want. Like, I'm keeping all of these because I'm not sure if I'm going to use them anymore again or something. But I'm just going to keep them. Now, Macintosh. Just check the system, library. Screen savers. Flurry saver. World of Day saver. I don't know any of those, so I'm not going to delete any of those. Just basically take everything that you don't need out. It's simple and it's easy, so yeah, you should do it. It's very nice. Cool. Yeah. Alright, so now that we got that done, another thing that will make your Mac less laggier is if you go to Wi-Fi, open network preferences. What you want to do, you want to make sure that it's connected to the airport. If your computer needs to be connected to the airport, sometimes it won't work if it's not connected to the airport, so just check. So I'm using this network. There's advanced, or there's this and everything stuff. Or sometimes you have to change it to make it less laggier for your computer. Yeah, just change some stuff. Yeah. Now, another thing is if you go to system preferences, you go to network. That. I think it was utilities. That globe. Yeah, software update. What you want to do is you want to go check now, and you want to put it on check for updates daily. Download updates automatically. If you wanted to download updates automatically, You could, but sometimes I don't like it because I don't know if I got an update. So, and then this is the installed software, everything that you installed, well, over everything. I wish there was actually like a clear button for this because some computers have a clear button and it actually makes this whole thing much more emptier, and then it makes it less, very, very less laggier. Trackpad, never mind. Displays. No! What am I doing? Alright. Never mind about that. Brightness, you could do that. I recommend just putting it in the middle because that's too bright. It will hurt your eyes. So yeah, that's another thing. Another thing was that if I went to utilities, which should be in here, airport utility, utilities, it's here somewhere. Did we? What the heck? I don't need this. Should be in utilities somewhere. Let's open that up. Airport utility, there. It's going to discover your Wi-Fi. See this thing. And then what you do is you can do a manual setup where basically you just need to put your Wi-Fi password. I'm putting mine in. Okay, so. And now you can do all these stuff. Now, I don't have to update this anymore, but you can update. Or I can update. Continue. So yeah, I am updating now, which is pretty cool. And that's something that you can see. I wasn't expecting this, but that's a good thing that you could do. Just update it. Going to update, it's gonna take a while. You see it's going by twos. In a nice speed. So here's the way. What you can't touch anything while it's updating, so you just leave it like this. Sometimes it will take over an hour. Sometimes it takes, like what I'm doing, like a few minutes or maybe less than a minute. Sometimes it's just going really, really fast, so it takes like 5 seconds to do it. So mine is almost done. Sometimes it will stop. There's nothing wrong if it stops. It's just really updating. It's just taking a long time. Like you see, it just stopped at 57%, and then it started going on again. So that's what it does. Now I'm just going to wait for this, which is not going to take a while. Or it will. What you can do is you can touch stuff, you can access stuff. Only the stuff that you can use without Wi-Fi. If you use something without Wi-Fi, it's not gonna work. So if I try to play, if I try to go on Safari, it will work because it's updating the Wi-Fi. So you can't use, like, you can't do that, Firefox, you can't do Safari, you can't do anything that needs Wi-Fi. So, everybody said, so it's almost done. There's other stuff here, actually. I'm just gonna add her. Now, if nobody of you knows what utilities is, there's some stuff in here that is useful that you might not know that you had. Because this is where you access Java if you want to update Java for your Minecraft and stuff like that, because if you don't update Java, your Minecraft could be laggy. Or sometimes for other games you need Java. I usually use Minecraft for Java. The software for this airport wireless has been successfully updated. You can close this window or wait for this airport extreme to start. I'll close the window. So now what I can do is, now, you don't have any Wi-Fi anymore because the airport extreme is just starting. So, yeah. Don't want that. So basically, what you can do to get your Mac less laggier. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later. Bye.